फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू योर ओन यूट्यूब चैनल सॉल्यूशन फॉर ऑल। फ्रेंड्स, इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड यू अबाउट पिक्टोग्राफ एंड बार ग्राफ। इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू लाइन ग्राफ। सो व्हाट इज लाइन ग्राफ एंड वेयर इज इट यूज्ड? फर्स्ट वी विल सी दैट। इन लाइन ग्राफ ईच वैल्यू इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय अ पॉइंट। All points are joined to form a line. Line graph is used to track changes over short and long periods of time. If you want to keep record of the changes for a short period or changes for a long period, then you have to make a line graph, like temperature of a year. You can maintain by using line graph, or that changes in weight of a particular man or woman or animal, these record you can keep in line graph. Or if you want to keep the record that what are the changes in your customers according to season or according to their age group or according to their economical condition, all these things, all types of changes, any changes is there, you can keep record. But mostly the record of temperature, record of share market, these records are kept in line graph. These records are kept in line graph. Let us take one example. So this is the monthly temperature, average monthly temperature of Delhi city for year 2019. In January, average temperature was 5 degrees Celsius, February 10 degrees Celsius, March 20 degrees Celsius, April 30, May 35, June 40, July 42, August 40, September 38, October 20, November 10 degree and December 7 degrees Celsius. These are the temperature of Delhi city for 2019. Now I have to keep the record. You can see there is a change in temperature. There is a change in temperature. So we will draw a line graph. For drawing a line graph, I have explained in my previous video also that you have to make two lines. One line is sleeping or horizontal line, and second line is standing or vertical line. Sleeping line will call x-axis and standing line will call y axis. Fine. And the meeting point of sleeping line and standing line, that is called origin O. Fine. That is zero. Now you have to write numbers. Numbers means average temperature on y axis and name of month in x axis. So name of month, first we will write here January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November and December. Fine. These are the names of months. So we will write here names of months. Fine. We will show it on x-axis, because whatever the number alphabets are there, that will come in x-axis and numbers will go in y-axis. Now for each and every graph, unit is very important. So how can we keep unit? I can take unit here. One unit is equal to 5 degrees Celsius. I will write here scale. One unit is equal to 5 degrees Celsius. So this is one unit, 5 degrees Celsius. Then this is 10 degree, 15 degree, 20 degree, 25 degree, 30 degree, 35 degree, 40 degree and 45 degree. No need to write more because our data is till 42 degree. So I have written here till 45 degree. Now I have to place the point. In January month, 5 degree is there. So January, here we will go up, and from here, from 5 degree side, we will come to right, and from January side, we will go to up. This point is for January. Now come to February, 10 degree from y axis, we will come to right, from x axis, we will go up. This is for February month. Then 20 degree, same way. This is for March month. Then for April month, 30 degree. For April month, 30 degree. For May, 35 degree. For May, 35 degree. For June, 35 degree. For May, 35. For June, 40 degree. For June, 40 degree. For July, 42 degree. So between 40 and 45, you have to keep in mind that it will come between, and you have to measure it according to the boxes inside one unit. How many boxes are there? According to that, you will make. So here it will come 42 degree. Then next one is August month, 40 degree. August month, 40 degree. Then September month, 38 degree. September month, 38. Again, it will come between 35 and 40. So just check where it will come. It will come somewhere here. This 38 degree. Then October month, 20 degree. October month, 20 degree. Then November month, 10 degree. And December month, 7 degree. Again, it will go up between, it will go between 5 and 10. So 7 degree, it will come somewhere here. Fine. Now join all these points with the help of scale. So first of all, we will join these two points, then next two, then next two. Then next two, then again, next two, again, next two, again, next two, then next two, then next two, next two, and next two. So by seeing this line graph, you can easily observe that how much variation is there in temperature. 5 degree, from 5 degree it goes to 42 degree, highest temperature of Delhi for 2019 is 42 degree. It was on the month of July, and lowest temperature, that is 5 degree Celsius, it was in the month of January. So with the help of this line graph, you can easily understand that what are the changes in temperature and how temperature goes up and how it comes down, in which month it is going up and in which month it is going down. So by this way, this line graph you can use for various purposes, like if you want to check the graph of your pulse rate, if you want to check the graph of your blood pressure, if you want to check the graph of your heartbeat, these all things can be recorded in form of graph, and that graph is line graph. If you want to check the share markets up and down, you have to draw line graph. So line graphs are very much useful, and I hope you all understood that how to draw line graph, what are the uses of line graph, and pie graph is there, that we will explain in next video. Till then, bye bye and enjoy.